how do you simplify a rational expression? So remember, rational expressions, we've also kind of called them algebraic fractions. We're going to go back to looking at how do we actually simplify a fraction. Now, this is something that a lot of you are probably doing pretty intuitively by now. You look at a number like 3/6 and you see 1/2. But why? Why is 3/6 the same as 1/2? Well, it's because these have a common factor. 3 is equal to 3 times 1. 6 is equal to 3 times 2. Now, if I have a fraction, what I know about multiplying fractions is that the product of the top and the product of the denominator is the only step to multiplying a fraction. So if I reverse that, I kind of go backwards here. I can see that this fraction right here is the same thing as this multiplication problem over here. But wait a second, 3/3 is just 1. So that kind of cancels out, it completely drops out of my problem. Again, a lot of you probably are not doing 3 steps when you simplify fractions, and I'm not suggesting that you should. But the really important thing to recognize here is what's happening. And what's happening is I'm pulling a common factor from the top and the bottom, and I'm canceling it as a 1. One thing to avoid here, right? If I had a problem like, 3/6, and I was trying to cancel that, and instead of looking for a factor, what if I said, oh, they both have a 3 in them. Okay, so 3 up top, that would be 3 + 0. 3 down bottom, that would be 3 + 3. Now, hopefully you recognize what I'm doing wrong here. I can't cancel this 3, right? That would leave me with 0/3. 3/6 is not the same thing as 0. So adding, when I'm pulling apart a sum, that doesn't help me cancel fractions. The only thing that's gonna help me cancel a fraction is factoring, pulling out common factors. Now, you may not have realized that back in 4th or 5th grade when you first learned this, that you were learning to factor, right? Factoring is something we've been doing a lot of this year with regards to quadratic expressions. But this is kind of where factoring all started. We factor numbers in order to simplify fractions. All right, so let's take a look at this one right here. If I now throw an x into it, not too much changes. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna factor the top, and then I'm gonna look for common factors in the bottom. Well, 3x doesn't really have any factors except 3x times 1. 3 can't be separated into anything, x can't be separated into anything. But in the bottom, 6x squared, that can be separated out. And there's a couple ways I could do that. But what I'm looking for is 3x, because I know that the 3x in the top is the only thing that's going to possibly cancel. Is 3x a factor of 6x squared? Yes, it is. 6x squared is 3x times 2x. The 3 times the 2 gives me 6. The x times the x gives me x squared. So I'm pulling apart this 6x squared as 3x times 2x. Now, 3x times something, 3x times something, this could be rewritten as 3x over 3x times 1 over 2x, and this would just cancel. So if I were simplifying this, I could simplify it down to 1 over 2x. Okay, how about this one in the bottom? Now to factor this, instead of just pulling numbers apart and looking for common factors, like 6 is 2 times 3, or x squared is x times x, here I'm gonna have to use the distributive property. Because factoring one of these isn't gonna help me. I need to factor this entire expression. And to do that, I basically reverse the distributive property. I say, what do 3x and 15 have in common? They both have a 3. Okay, so 3 times what would give me 3x plus 15? Well, 3 times x would give me the 3x, and 3 times 5 would give me the 15. So 3 times x is that, 3 times 5 is that. Good. All right, now in the bottom, these both have a 6 in common. However, what am I really looking for? Well, I'm looking for either 3 or x plus 5. Because that's what I want to cancel. And in this case, I see that they both have a 3 in common here. 6x and 12 have a 3. So if I pull that out, I'd be left with 2x plus 4. Because 3 times 2x would give me 6x. 3 times 4 would give me the 12. So I've reversed the distributive property. Now, again, I could have pulled out a 6. And I still would have then seen 3 over 6, and I would have been able to cancel it. But what I'm looking for, as I'm factoring the top and bottom, are common factors, things that are going to cancel. So now, 3 over 3, again, it's 3 times something, and 3 times something, that's going to cancel. So this entire expression would just simplify to x plus 5 over 2x plus 4. Let's do a couple other examples like that. All right, so let's say I had a problem like this. 15x to the 5th over 9x squared. All right, all I'm doing is just looking for common factors top to bottom. So I'm going to look at numbers and variables separately in this case because there's only one term. So 15 has the factors of 5 times 3, 9 has the factors of 3 times 3, right? So I know they both have a 3, and what's left up here is a 5, what's left down here is a 3. X to the 5th and x squared, well, x to the 5th is x squared times x to the 3rd, so the x to the squareds cancel, the 3s cancel, and I'm just left with 5x to the 3rd over 3. Just by canceling out any common factors that I had top to bottom. Okay, what about if I had something like this? 4x plus 10 over 6x minus 6. All right, so in the top, in order to factor this, I need to use my distributive property. I have two terms. Right? Factoring just one term isn't going to help me. I could do it. I could say 4x is 2 times 2x, but I can't cancel that 2 because it's being added to the 10. So I need to find a factor of this entire thing. What is a factor of 4x plus 10? Well, they both have a 2 in common. So I pull out 2, and I'm left with 2 times 2x would give me the 4x, 2 times 5 would give me the 10. Down bottom. At this point, I'm not really asking myself, what do these have in common? Instead, I'm asking myself, do these have a factor of either 2 or 2x plus 5? Because that's the only thing that's going to cancel. I could pull a 6 out of these, right? And that would probably help me if that's the only thing I saw, because then 2 over 6, I would see, okay, that cancels to 1 over 3. But instead, I'm just looking to see, do these have a 2? And they do. So I would just pull out the 2 here. So now I've got 3x, because 2 times 3x would give me 6x, minus 3. The 2s cancel, and the answer here, the simplified version of this, is 2x plus 5 over 3x minus 3.